So the visionaries, here we go.
Well, let's go ahead and talk about the process. First, you worked as a writing duo.
Yeah.
To bring this to the page. Yeah.
For most of the stuff that we write, that we're a writing duo, yeah.
How many of you know them already?
Woo!
Y'all are famous. There was, what year was this that you were at Fringe and had the Red Death? I think about this thing all the time.
We took a the theater and we've done do a lot of shows at the Kansas City Fringe Festival in July, and we've done 15 years, something like that. We do a show every year, so 15 shows.
So Red Death was a thing.
Red Death was 15? 2000.
It was an opera.
15
something. Oh my God. And so very rich tapestry. I think that's what you work in. I think that's what we see here. How much of this was I think you requested, tell me about the concept and how you conceived of the story.
Let's start there. Several years ago, I've spoken at a meeting at the IFC, and this woman came up to me afterwards, and she gave me her card, which I still have right here. And it's got a picture on it and her name, and it says background actor.
Oh.
And that's what she was. All she wanted to do was be on movie set in the background. She didn't want lines, she didn't want a role, she didn't want a job or anything else. She just wanted to be in the background on movie sets. And she,
it literally says that on the back. I just want to be in the background.
Oh my gosh.
And that kind of inspired us to come up with this idea of an actor. How does an actor audition for this part? You know, you might see someone you know in a commercial. I know they make a lot of commercials here locally, and you might see an actor you know and you go, they had an audition for that part. And sometimes they have to make a fool of themselves, but you know, it's like they were happy to get that role. So, and we're two people who actually read the credits of movies and see who's on.
I always stay for the below the line. Yes,
we're the last ones out. We're watching every single word.
So we're very aware of who the dead players are and who is like, oh, who is that guy? I know that guy.
Yeah.
So that's kind of where it all started.
So that's the kernel. I want to know about the process because you did this specifically for this program.
It actually was first written as a 10-minute stage play. And then when I heard about the program, I kind of adapted it into a screenplay and changed things here and there to make it more like a screenplay.
And was the thought process just to write a screenplay, or did you think about writing a screenplay that would kind of create
That's giving us a lot of credit. No,
yeah, I didn't know anything about the mentorship program. Sorry.
Okay, well then how do they find you?
How do they find
you? You didn't know anything about the mentorship program.
Well, when we wrote it. Sure, I didn't know.
No, it was an open call. There were several scripts that were entered into the, I don't know how many, several scripts that were entered and came down to three finalists, and they had a night where they did readings of all the finalists, and everybody got to pick the ones that liked the best. And so we had to be one of the finalists, and I guess people liked our script. And that's kind of how it all came to pass.
Oh, so there was like a little writer's contest component to it.
And all the finalists are here, by the way.
All of the finalists are here?
Two of them are.
Okay, you want all y'all to know that two of the other finalists are here. The writer's contest. You want to raise your hands? Give you a round of applause. Oh, that's very interesting. I don't know if I remember that from the early stages. I'm going to go ahead and open it up for some questions because we are going to get you on over to that bowling alley here. Any questions? And I'll go ahead if you can, please stand.
Yeah, I just had a question since you mentioned that you've written this prior.
great question was the original version, because it was for the stage, about theater actors rather than.
I think Bryan had the initial idea, and I was an actor for a number of decades, and and he was like, "Hey, tell me about some of the craziest auditions you've ever had." And I was like, "Okay, sit down," because so auditioning is really, really hard. And so I just had a whole bunch of stories from me and then some people that I knew, and we were like, sometimes it's just you do everything in an audition, and then just one audition that I had is they literally had us have to do, "Hey, I'm actually a theater actor."
Yeah.
So yeah, I don't. Do I need that?
No.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah.
Do it. I'm told to do it. Yeah.
So anyway, I So there's that one that I did. That I did the monologue, and they said, "Do you have another one?" And I did another one, and they said, "Do you have another one?" And I did another one.
Wow.
Said, "Oh yeah, and what's your song?" And I did my song. He said, "Oh, do you have another one?" And I said, "Yeah, sure." And I did another one. And I left there, and I had done like four monologues and three songs. And they said, "Well, you know, everything's cast for this season."
Wow. God damn.
And that was kind of what happened and where that went.
But yes, it was always written for film, because in theater you don't really have bit parts. So it was all about film.
Right on. And we're going to. Sydney, you had a question.
Yeah, so a lot of times in writing for film, it's the writer ends up being the director or the editor. They're often with the process through the beginning to the end. Not always the case. There are other times when you're the writer of the film, and then you give them the script, and they go off and they make your movie, and then you see it.
Mm.
It can be a very interesting process, because when you're making a film, you kind of make it three times: when you write it, when you film it, and when you edit it.
Are you asking them, are they pleased with the end product?
Not only yes. But also, there's that what ended up on the screen versus what was in your head when looking at the page. These are always different things.
You don't have to answer this.
And we still have bowling. We have bowling.
Everybody written a script or acted in a film or done any role has an idea of what things are going to be like. And then you see the finished product.
Sure.
It's always different.
Yeah.
Yes.
And if it's worse, hopefully it's better different.
Sometimes it's exactly the same thing.
But I actually really enjoy this question, but I would like to kind of take it to another angle. If we can ask what you envisioned and what you saw, how do you think it was affected by going through a mentorship program rather than these filmmakers producing it on their own?
That's a tougher question.
Tougher? Okay, I was trying.
You have a script on a piece of paper, it's not going to be the same as what you end up on film or on video. And you expect that, and you understand that, and you know there's a process to it.
And we go into film because it's collaborative.
You want that process. And we're on the spot, but I can say yes. Very pleased with the results. I can say it's like 90% what I was expecting the film to be, and a lot of what they added, but the other 10% was really good ideas that improved the story, so Not about to say that because all the filmmakers are at this moment. So.
I think the cast was really strong.
I think the cast was very strong. I really like that.
Mm-hmm.
They did an awesome job, really. I'm not kidding. And I think that it was really close to what I was thinking. And what they did add was all the cutaways to the bank. That we did not write that. And I think that it worked really well. I think it was a great idea. So that was fantastic.
Well, I don't have a dog in the fight. I'm going to say that the end product was beautiful. And I want to congratulate you all for the work that you've done here. We're going to go ahead and wrap it up, if that's okay, because I think everybody wants to get their bowling on. Go ahead and give the writers another round.